Thank you very much.
We are Canadian Brass as representative. However, that is of course not the first music you're going to hear us play here tonight. That was just a closer walk with the, and it represents our first encore. We discovered years ago to never leave that to chance. I would like to begin the program proper by performing the most important work from the wonderful catalog of works by Johann Sebastian Bach. We're going to perform the fugue in G minor, perhaps the most perfect fugue by Bach, albeit normal, but perfect fugue by Bach. There's another fugue also in G minor by Bach known as the Great Fugue. You may be familiar with the title of that, not the music itself. And you would therefore assume that there is a Great Fugue and then this little fugue, and that somehow we're withholding this Great Fugue playing this lousy little fugue. Given this duration, perhaps this is even greater than the Great Fugue. We'd like to play it tonight as the Great Little Fugue in G minor.
Creating the first stereophonic surround sound.
So Chuck sits wherever he wants. Because we play music from our iPads, and we love it if you can help us hold our music tonight. The thing we'd ask is you just don't push the on-off button all the time. So.
that was Enrique Crespo's Vals Peruano, or Peruvian Waltz. Enrique Crespo is actually from Uruguay, but he lives in Stuttgart, Germany. So it's quite an international event, this piece. We're going to keep it in the Latin theme, though, and move to Spain with a Spanish piece by composer Agustin Lara. And this is going to feature our trumpet player, Chris Coletti, on a big, beautiful piece called Granada.
Thank you. Thank you. Which sounds like if Bach had been in New Orleans. And now I'd like to end our first half with one of the most famous pieces from Spain. It's called El Relicario, which I don't know what it means. So last week, we thought it would be a good idea to find out what it means. So there's no explanation, actually, if you go to Google Translate, El Relicario translates to El Relicario. But if you type just Relicario on Google, the first thing that comes up, it's a beautiful hotel. In Mexico, not even in Spain. So, although this piece is from Spain, it's gonna have some Mexican flair to it, like mariachi. This is El Relicario by Jose Pizzo.
Thank you.
like to put with a piece that's so famous it's probably on your cell phones as a ringtone. Chris, can you help us out? That's right, I have learned my small melody. But this piece is a reimagination of Beethoven's original theme. It takes that motive and it develops it. Time after time, it comes back more and more complex until the very end, it explodes into an epic grand finale. This is Beethoven's Führer.
Thank you.
established earlier that the piccolo trumpet is probably the second hardest instrument out here. So we're going to feature it one more time. Thomas Fats Waller, incredible composer, incredible pianist, jazz composer, jazz pianist. And he wrote a piece called Handful of Keys for himself to showcase his abilities. And it's just an amazing, fast, flary thing. And you would never listen to this piece and think, wow, that should be a piccolo trumpet piece. And that's what it is in this version. Of course, the handful of keys refer to the keys of the piano in the original, and the handful of keys will be the keys of Caleb's piccolo trumpet. Now, not only is the piccolo trumpet a very difficult instrument, but it's a very dangerous instrument, believe it or not. You see, a lot of pressure builds up in the player's head because it's so small. So the trumpet's so small. And you could very well just blow the air right off. I know this sounds a little unbelievable, but you'll have to take my word for it. I used to play this piece, and now I have to wear this wig.
More than 25 years various things that they do during the music. And from their very lucid descriptions, we have recreated the original National Ballet of Canada choreography. So please sit back and hopefully enjoy our tribute to the ballet.
Thank you.
At the end of the program, They go out into the lobby and autograph CDs and said, great, it increases the sales. And we should make exactly the same announcement. So at the end of the program, if you'd like CDs autographed, Larry Dunn will be